welcome here to Talk FCB and welcome back to the channel, guys. As of course, we are going to be reacting in full here to Barça coming up against Athletic Club this evening. It was a tough one. I think we all expected that coming into this game. It is never, ever an easy place to go, San Mames. And tonight, we have dropped points in the second game of the season. It's Athletic 1, Barça 1. On a different day, I think it could have gone either way, to be honest. Athletic certainly had their chances. We two in the second half had a chance to win the game. We're going to be talking about it all. So let's start right here. Because in terms of the starting lineup, Ronald Koeman there pretty much surprising nobody with that lineup. It was exactly the same as the team that beat Real Sociedad in that first game of the season. And quite honestly, I can understand that. You know, it was a very, very good performance at the Camp Nou. I didn't feel as though it was the same sort of Barca that we saw in this game here. We didn't really do enough, particularly there in the early stages of the game. We allowed Athletic to really come into it. But I just want to have a word here on Eric Garcia. I think obviously on the footballing side of things tonight, he had a tough game up against Iñaki Williams, even then as well, when his brother came on in the second half. And of course, late on in that second half, Eric Garcia did receive a straight red card. But what some of you may or may not know is, just before the game, Eric Garcia was actually informed that his grandfather had passed away. Now, he was told that literally just before the game kicked off. I was surprised that he even played tonight. Honestly, I don't understand how he did. I think this is certainly a game where maybe he should have sat it out, because clearly he was affected. And it's only normal, it's only natural. And I just want to say there, all of our very best thoughts going out to Eric Garcia, who tonight would have been really struggling. And our thoughts are with him. But I think, like I say, starting the game there, Athletic Club's game plan was very, very clear. They were coming with a clear high press. And in particular, they were really trying to target their Neto. I think they saw him as a real weakness. He didn't fill me with confidence, got to say, right throughout the game in terms of his distribution. But even so, the first big chance of the game, it did fall to Barca. And this is one of those where, again, if you take this chance early on, it's an entirely different game, but it's a huge miss. Because Memphis does really, really well. He gets himself inside the area. He maneuvers round defenders, gets to the byline, cuts the ball back, and it's right there. It's almost on a plate gift wrap there for Martin Braithwaite in front of goal, but he blazes it over, and that is an absolutely huge miss there in the early stages of the game. And things, like I say, could have been very, very different. From that moment on, you've got to say in the first half, it was solely Athletic. They threatened there through Iñaki Williams. Eric Garcia certainly was having problems containing him, Piqué as well, whilst he was on the field. And of course, on the 10-minute mark, they clattered the crossbar. It was a brilliant, brilliant effort there. They worked it in from the left-hand side. It was actually Sanset there who turned brilliantly and lashed one towards our goal. Neto could only stand and stare. He didn't even have a chance to blink there. That should have been the opener, and they were very, very unlucky. They continued putting more and more pressure on. Neto again giving it away in a really dangerous area. Again, they were pressing him high, and it was only Frenkie de Jong this time, after we'd given the ball away in such a dangerous area, that he was the one to rescue us. Brilliant block that it was, the last-ditch challenge to deny Iñaki Williams there in front of goal. But like I say, Gerard Piqué did not last the entire game. He was subbed off there on the 30th minute mark for Ronald Araujo. And that's an interesting one, because I wonder there, is it something that Gerard Piqué had picked up during the game? Was it a problem there that was caused by a challenge, an impact injury? Or was it what was reported before the game even started? Was Piqué not right to start this game? And if that is the case, for me, he shouldn't have even been playing in the first place. I don't know why we took that risk. So Piqué there going off injured, but Araujo very nearly got us into the lead. It was so, so unlucky, I feel, on our part there. It was a ball that we played in towards the back post. Really good header there. He rises well, Martin Braithwaite, puts it back into the danger area. Goalkeeper spills it, and it falls to Araujo. He's got his back to goal. He bicycle kicks it into the back of the net. Barca, just before half-time, it would have been the perfect time to score, but no. Referee there whistles. They disallow the goal, seemingly pointing at Martin Braithwaite for the header that he won, the fact that he rose there. But that seems so, so harsh to me. And it was also the way they played on. If that was the foul there, you blow up immediately. You don't let then the play carry on through one phase and another. Goalkeeper has time to spill the ball. He actually takes out Eric Garcia in the process. Then Araujo finishes it off, and then the referee decides that actually it was a foul a few seconds earlier. So for me there, very, very strange decision. The Athletic players did not even appeal when the ball went in. That was one thing. The players on the field, very, very confused. Koeman was unhappy. Gerard Piqué as well, arguing with the referee at halftime. But somehow, after that opening 45 minutes, chances for Athletic, a few for Barca, but the scoreline was 0-0. However, to be fair, it didn't take long in the second half for that to change. And you have to say, Barca, we were hoping we were going to come out a different kind of team. We were going to come out with a different kind of attitude and mentality with some sort of change. Did that happen? No, it didn't. It really, really didn't. Straight away from the first exchanges there of the second half, Athletic again were putting the pressure on. Long ball in it was. Iñaki Williams again running in behind. Neto coming off his line. And it was only thanks again to Araujo, who did really, really well, you've got to say, after he came on, clearing it off the line in acrobatic fashion. Spectacular clearance there. Last-ditch challenge that saves us from a certain goal, but it didn't take much longer. Athletic then with a corner, whipped in. It was an outswing corner. Nothing special, nothing too spectacular, but it was a simple ball in. Iñigo Martinez gets away from his man, headers it into the back of the net, and that there gave Athletic what you have to say, and I'm going to be honest and say that was a very much deserved lead for them at the time. They really put the pressure on us, and they deserved to take the lead with that goal. Then on the 60th minute, Mark Koeman taking off Pedri, taking off Braithwaite. On came Roberto and Youssef Demir. And I've got to say then, Barca did improve. We did start having more possession. Whether Athletic got tired, you don't really know. I think they certainly dropped back a little bit and Barca had a bit more possession. De Jong created something out of nothing. Brilliant, brilliant moment from him there. Inside the area just about. Keeper slightly off his line. De Jong sees something there that nobody else even think about. He just lifts it over the goalkeeper. It looks like it's going to be a wonderful goal, but in the end, cannons off the crossbar. Really, really unlucky there from De Jong. Again, Barca, close to a goal, but couldn't quite get it. But on the 75th minute mark, finally, we actually made our chance pay, because this time, we actually win the ball nice and high up the field there. We win it off Athletic in their last line. They're then in a very dangerous, exposed area. Roberto, I think, actually does really well here. He gets in front of his man, plays the ball over the top to Memphis, who's onside. And this is the really nice thing about this move is, he gets that ball, brings it down well. He's got one thought in his mind. He is going to get there into the area, in on goal, and he's going to shoot for goal, and he's going to score. It is a wonderful, wonderful finish, this, from Memphis Depay on his left-hand side. Has a little look. Whack! Full smash, straight in the back of the net. Absolutely fantastic. And the annoying thing is, and it's so frustrating, because he could have had another. And it was actually an easier chance the second time round than it was the first. That was a wonderful goal from a tight angle, and then we just 5 minutes to go. He could double his tally. De Jong plays him in. The angle here is not as tight. He's got more time to pick out his finish. But maybe there he just overthinks it. He drags it wide in the end. That could have been the winner for Barca. And even despite all the pressure that we were under, all the chances that Athletic had, we were actually the ones close to winning this game. And I've got to say, guys, in general, for me, this is kind of mixed emotions, mixed opinions, because on the one hand, Athletic, for me, dominated this game. They had the much, much better chances. They pressed us really high. They had much more energy. They had the home crowd behind them. And I think we really struggled. For most of this game, we didn't really get out of our half. You didn't get the good players involved. You didn't get Griezmann on the ball enough. Memphis only really started to get it in the second half. I thought De Jong was brilliant, brilliant for Barcelona, our best player on the day. But apart from that, we didn't really do an awful lot. Yes, we had unlucky moments there with that Araujo disallowed goal. Memphis could have won it at the end. But I think at the end of the day, I will gladly take a point here. It was a tough game. I think it's a game that we could have lost. We could have easily lost this game. And you would have said, you know what? Athletic deserved to win it. Fair enough. But no, we have found a way to get ourselves a goal. Brilliantly taken goal it was by Memphis. We move on now. It's still early in the season. This point could be a crucial one at the end. But what do you think? What did it make of the game tonight? We knew it was going to be tough. We knew it wasn't going to be easy. A big test here that I wouldn't say we've overcome. There's plenty to learn from. Plenty here to improve upon. Let me know how you felt about this display. And what sort of changes do you want to see to this Barca team in the future to avoid these kind of displays? Let me know all of that in the comments down below, guys. As here, we just fall short. I'll be seeing you, though, soon, of course, with more videos. And until next time, as always, Vizca, El Barça.